big thing is, guys, stay calm, stay cool. We'll get you all in and have a great time, all right?
This is our first U2 concert. We're like so excited. Are you so excited?
Very excited.
Yeah, so I'm pretty excited.
Yeah, we made necklaces.
We made the necklace. Bono.
I've never been to a live show, even though I've dreamt about it like for about 5 years every day.
I was hoping that you would actually say okay and play the house.
You've been the backbone and the music of my life.
Oh, that's me and two guys from the north side of Dublin. And we played some music one night.
Douglas.
They love their fans, and I think Bono loves coming out talking to us. I think he really, really thrives off of all of us.
We've always liked playing arenas, so we kind of adopt the arena and as a perfect way to stage U2.
The audience is obviously a huge part of any show like this. It's about a relationship the band have had over the years with the people of Chicago.
That's the Joshua Tree logo, and I've been a fan for quite some time.
Degree black belt in Taekwondo, so I'm hoping those ninja skills and concentration will help me get into the floor space. That is what I'm hoping will help us get in.
We've been here since way early in the morning. We're exhausted, but so excited to be here.
I've never been to a show where there's been so much energy. You know, there's just 40,000 fans, like everyone's in the show. Like, you know, Bono always says that it's the church of the people, and it's really true. I mean, there's such an energy and like a life force about it.
From what I understand, it's randomly selected tickets that are allowed into the Ellipse.
To be in the middle of an exciting rock and roll band's performance really makes it feel as if you are part of the show.
My day started yesterday at 4:20 a.m. Flew in from Charlotte to here. Got here in line at 9 a.m. the day before the show. Been here ever since, and I look like it.
What we understand the lottery system is that it's pretty much luck of the draw. You get in line, and if you get beat, I guess, when your ticket's scanned, and then you get to stand by the Ellipsis.
We've had to change between the last tour and this tour the way that people get those tickets. Because it used to be that they were available to the people who stood in line longest. And the result of that was that the large number of people who follow the tour around from town to town, they would be in that part of the stage every single night. It wasn't conducive for an exciting performance because they knew what was going to happen each night. So we've refined the system, and those tickets are now distributed on a random basis. So you have as much chance, if you have a floor ticket, of getting into the Ellipse as anyone else when you come into the building at the beginning of the evening.
Even if we're not inside the Ellipse, we're still going to have great seats right in probably the front row, right along the catwalk thing. So.
Hey, Jake. You got to get your blood pressure taken, all right? I'd like to say it's a ritual. If it's bad, just fucking tell them it's good.
Jake, it's fantastic.
See? The blood pressure is good.
Scotty!
How are you, buddy?
How are you? Why are you limping? Are you not playing soccer?
No, I'm just a commentator at the game.
I like that. You have the right accent for it.
I think so, don't you? I want to tell you something very secretive. The girl I admire most walking down the hallway right now. Come on.
Stop.
You remember that night? I'm sorry.
Jake.
It's all right.
We're a good example of, like, how relevant they still are, you know, because we're in our early 20s and there's fans out here that are in their 50s and just, you know, they captivate everyone in between. And my little sister's 14 years old and she went to Elevation with me in Dallas and she's all about it too. So it's a real testament to the kind of music that they make and how relevant they still are.
We usually arrive at a design for the show after 6 months, 9 months. This time, we're able to refine the design into the ellipse shape we have. And it's actually a Vertigo logo if you look at it from above. And it was Bono's idea to use that shape.
The idea behind that is so the band kind of get rid of the barrier of a stage and an audience. You know, that's always something that this band have tried to break down. For anybody in the ellipse, they see the show in an entirely different way than the people who are in the expensive seats up beyond. They see something that's much more immediate. They're really right there.
A minute of City of Blinding Lights, please. Just, this is a test. Just for facts check.
I come to this gig as a massive, massive U2 fan, and my vision is to try and capture the fantastic, almost spiritual experience that a U2 gig is.
So what I want here is kind of symmetry, so tilt it straight up from there. Lovely, yeah. Great, stop! Keep Bono in, yeah.
You know, they have a fantastic sense of theatre, great band, great music, and, you know, the responsibility to capture that, to put it onto DVD in a way that's really going to move a fan when they watch it, you know, make them kind of leap up and kind of feel the joy and the exuberance that you feel when you're at a U2 concert. That's my vision, you know. It's just to kind of get the truest, most amazing response from the viewer that watches that DVD in wherever they're watching it, you know.
I think we've always just regarded film and videotape as a natural tool for keeping in touch with and communicating with the audience. And this format really is new and exciting, and we want to get as much out of it and into it as possible.
When we're handheld, ideally in your close-ups, I want to see the screens, where the screens are down soft behind them. So I don't want it, because otherwise it looks quite ordinary.
Okay. You start out. I'll say hello, hello, and you do the olas. Can you do that? All right.
Uno,
dos, tres, catorce!
Lights go down, it's dark,
the jungle is your head.
Can't rule your heart, you're feeling so much stronger than.
I thought your eyes were wide and know your soul. You can
be born like you want to.
Place called
Vertigo.
Donde esta?
Everything I wish I didn't know.
But you give me something I can feel.
I look after the Edge's guitars. In the studio, I look after all the band's guitars and Adam's bass. Any other group I work with, I'll spend maybe 2 or 3 hours a day stringing. But with Edge, for Edge's world, it's about 8 or 9 hours of stringing. It's very flattering to take care of the Edge's sounds. I mean, that's, you can imagine, one of the greatest guitarists in the world and getting to do his sounds.
Hello.
Hey, you're fantastic,
Ed. Good luck tonight. Thanks, Ed, for coming up. Appreciate it.
Okay, God bless. God
bless. Thanks for coming up.
Some Guinness for you, my brother and I brought you some Guinness.
Thank you.
Wow,
can I have a copy of that?
Yeah, you can take it.
Can I have a kiss?
We're trying to make the whole be greater than the sum of the parts. That's the thing with a YouTube show. Any other rock band, they go to play the tunes and they fuck off. And we play the tunes and we fuck off. But when we get it right, it just feels like one tune. Is what I'm trying to say. Hey, darling.
Marla, we can use this. Next tour's going to be
careful now. See you around, fellas. All right.
Thank you so much.
The show is constantly being refined, even right to the very end of the tour. And it's not because we're dissatisfied necessarily, but we just want to keep the thing alive.
Willie, there's no chance you'll be able to make out any of these images if the strobe lights and stuff going on the background.
And so quite often in rehearsals, we'll just get the basic show up and running, and then we gradually refine each area of the show.
The challenge for making a film like this is really to try and deliver for the band something that they can be proud of and something that they can say, yeah, that is what we're on about. Not just about lights and video screens and guitars, and but also about the feel of the philosophy of the show and where that's coming from.
Going into this job, I have a sense of what I want to look like at the other end, and that sense of what I want to look like is born from me standing in the pit, watching a couple of shows at the back of the house, and watching a couple of shows from the side of the stage, you know? I want it to be a brilliant record for fans. I want them to feel that they are in the concert, enjoying it, and they get every view that they couldn't get from just one night seeing it, you know? If you came to see this show probably 15, 20 times, then you'd probably not need to buy the DVD. Except you'd want to play it again and again and again and again and go, yeah, it's all, yeah, that's what it's all about for me.
Okay, Zoo Station.
I put the glass on like we did that. My name is Gavin. Mr. Friday. Gavin Friday. I'm a friend of the band. I know the band all my life. I think I met Bono when I was about 11 or 12 years of age on Cedarwood Road, which is a little street in the north side of Dublin. And we grew up together.
Gav, will you give me a read on which you prefer?
It's like a brotherhood between us. We throw things by each other, you know? So I'm sort of like aesthetic bodyguard, visual bodyguard. And then I'm like midwife. You know, if they're starting a tour, I come and I pull that baby out by the neck, you know. I say, come on, get up, stand, walk, run, jump, smile. Uncle Gavin loves you.
Hold on.
on stick.
The piece of video that now opens Zoo TV, Zoo Station rather, the Zoo TV section, is new this week. It appeared in Chicago. And again, it's just one of those ideas that came up in the dressing room and we follow through.
John Abraham, Bono's youngest son, is sitting at the table and I go, here, say mama, mama, mama. Mama, 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 mama! You get it?
Amongst many ideas we had for the tour, I wanted to be able to use video, but more importantly, I wanted to be able to get rid of it all. And the solution we came up with were these video curtains, which can drop in out of nowhere. The audience behind can see through them, and there's picture on both sides, of course. But then it can all roll up and go away. The LED curtains, the pixel panels, we made them. Originally, we'd imagined that they would be infinitely fine filaments with tiny little video pixels on. And as you see, the reality at the moment is more like tennis balls on rope. But they really work, and they've really been a talking point because you can't quite believe what you're seeing, that these things can come out of nowhere.
Whoa, that's fantastic.
A little birthday ice cream, too.
Thank you very much. Wow.
Thank you.
Give me a kiss. That's my birthday.
Thank you so much.
Wow. That is really, really cool. Thank you very much. Happy Thanks, everybody.
How's it feel to be in front of all those people?
I love it!
For 48 hours. 48 hours.
We would do this for nobody, not Madonna. Only you two.
We got about 5-10 minutes before we enter.
Not much more.
Hopefully not much more. A pint of Guinness afterwards. A pint of Guinness before, we're fine.
Is this winners? Yes. These people won a competition to get the backstage tour. They don't get guaranteed anything. They get guaranteed a show where the dressing room are, where the stage is. But sometimes they'll bump into celebrities, like myself. Yes. Most of my job as a production manager is done before the event, advancing it and making sure that we have the right amount of labor, the right amount of power. Organizing a stage dance with a local promoter and things like that. It really gets a little easier on a day-to-day thing. Yes, Bruce.
Can I get Bart just to bring down your truss so we can get the technique so we can get the hot head off?
I'll bring you down tonight after the show? Absolutely, we'll do that.
Okay.
Dennis Sheehan, tour manager extraordinaire, the best guy around here.
With the Irish Times.
Big job in life to make sure everybody has a copy of the Irish Times.
We have to keep up with home, you know.
Yeah.
Just to see what's going on when we're away.
He keeps the band in order. Everybody thinks they do. It's him, really. If he didn't get him here for the 4 o'clock sound check at 4:30, it would never happen.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm front, guys. Next. Let's do it.
Guys, you gotta get a wristband.
Alrighty. Yeah! Yeah! Right here. Oh! Yes! Yes!
cool. I like it.
All right, so it has nothing to do with you two. You're just like, hey, we're on a show.
Yeah, just
on
decided
the count. To just, yep. Are you on the floor?
Yes, we are. I'm a little mad that there's not a lot of grass to eat around here for grazing.
Hey, we sing Panavision Insurance. I thought we did. They're just good every night.
I heard that the show we are going to see tonight is a kind of back to the roots style. I mean, you play old songs, also news, of course, but it's energetic rock and roll. Is it true?
Well, what we've done is, like, just to kind of surprise people and kind of change it up a bit, is we're playing quite a lot of songs. Well, not a lot, maybe four songs, depending on the night, from the Boy album. And it's just, you know, that middle period, we're not playing quite so much from the Joshua Tree. We're kind of letting that have a rest for a while.
The Change! 30 minutes, going to Channel 60.
Vaguely, what that means is the Kings of Leon are finished, and we're getting ready to start the YouTube performance, so we'll get into a set change.
Good luck. Thanks.
I'll see ya. Look, it's the Kings of Leon just finished their wonderful set.
Hi, Paul, and this is Jonathan Clark calling to let you know that we're in the Ellipse in Chicago. We're at the very, very front. We're going to be staring at Adam and Bono. We're excited, and you know, hopefully we'll be like this in Philly next week. Have a good night.
This is amazing.
I'm so happy you can see straight.
Yeah, I know. Did I walk down those stairs? I don't know. We'll see.
Hey,
I went in first and I didn't get it, and then he did. I got so excited. We came from Mexico City just to see them.
Guys, this is the final preparation after the Kings of Leon. Notice I don't physically do any work. We're getting ready to shoot this thing tonight.
Hamish?
Yes.
Question. There are times when Bono's out on the Ellipse, and there are times when the Ellipse is very interesting on a wider shot because there are lights and tracking around it. Would you like some of those maybe compressed? You want me to vary them?
Vary it. Totally mix it up. You're a real wild card camera. Whenever those discs, whenever those things are spinning, and yeah, special miracle drug, really important. Because at the beginning of miracle drug, you're the only person. Because that thing's going round, you can just kind of make it out. It's like, bang, you're there, you've got it, it's gold.
I'll be there.
What else? Anybody else got any?
Clean audience tonight at all, ever?
Huh?
Clean audience?
No. No. Want to feel the love, don't want to give it a name.
I will poach you.
Feel the love, don't give me the name. Other than that, just really, really enjoy it. It's real, real kind of like the best people here to shoot the best band in the world. What, you know, what more can be more fun than that? And I promise I'm not going to scream, only with joy. I love my
everyone.
Back hair moment from back.
30 seconds. House
Chicago. Beautiful city.
It was awesome. It was
really
cool.
It was the best ever.
Waited patiently for the law. You climb and heard my cry.
Beautiful day.
Lift me up out of the pit. Out of the miry clay. I was singing your song.
Number four in line.
Number two.
You believe it or not. I mean, I was there all day.
Sweet, man. Yeah. So many songs, great songs. I can't even speak anymore. I lost my voice.
When they played One, and I was like, ah, like heartbreaking, but amazing. It was great.
We came straight out of Sweden to see this show, and it's a blast, man.
Fantastic.
Helt jävla fantastisk, alltså.
When Bono said to Adam Clayton, "What's got into this man?" I love that Adam was all over the stage.
This is for Father Sidney at Notre Dame University. This is for you.
Cannot explain it. Live altering concert. Thank you.
Lose your voice too.
Show was fabulous. Stage was fantastic. The oval shape, it was great. Some of our friends were on the inner circle, we were not, but it was great fun. Music was good, a good mix of everything.
The best show in the world.